Sister has asked a very good question. That if someone does very bad, what is the punishment recommended by Allah in the Quran? Depending upon the sin done, we have to realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got various ways of guiding the person. One of them, as you mentioned, is that if someone does a sin, then there is a punishment for that. On the other hand, that if you don't do that sin, then there's a reward for you. So one of the aspects is, if you don't do this, if you don't drink alcohol, there's a reward for you. If you don't do zina, there's a reward for you. And the reward will be here, also in the akhirah. But the point to be noted, depending upon the sin, is the punishment given. But Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 48, and Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 116, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He pleases, He may forgive any sin, but the sin of shirk He will never forgive. Shirk, associating partners with God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive. Any other sin, if He pleases, He may forgive. So we as Muslims, what we should do, that if we see someone doing sin, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that if you see anything wrong, if you can stop it with the hand, stop it with the hand. If you cannot stop it with the hand, then stop it with the tongue. If you can't stop it with the tongue, the least you can do is curse in your heart, and then you will be the lowest level of mu'min, believer. And Allah says that whenever you see something wrong, Allah says in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 110, تَأْمِرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, that enjoin what is good and forbid what is wrong and believe in Allah. So if we as Muslims see someone committing a sin, we have to da'wah and islah with that person and tell that person it's a sin, you should not do it, and try and convince him with Quran and Sunnah and with reason and logic. Hope that answers the question, sir.